And here they are again. These are our exception and compression attributes. They're all listed in one place here. So you can see we've got exception, deviation, min and max. We've got compression, deviation, min and max. And if you take a look at where they are in our point builder here, here's a pi tag. If we see them right here, this is our compression and exception deviation. The default exception deviation is one engineering unit. The default compression deviation is two engineering units. They say I can show them either way, but those are the defaults. And the default max time for the exception test is 10 minutes. The default max time for the compression test is 8 hours. So if 8 hours goes by and we don't store a value that passes the deadband, then we simply store the next snapshot value that comes in. So these are our defaults. You can see them all, you know, grouped together here in one place. And there is a reason for caution when dealing with zero and span with some of our editing tools. If you're using the, or just keep in mind that if you're using percentage of span, if you've chosen percentage of span for how you're going to determine exception and the exception deviation and the compression deviation, then if you do change your span, that's going to have an effect on your data compression. So keep an eye out for that. If you are making changes to zero and span, that will affect anything whose values for exception and compression have been defined as percentage of span. Now, one last thing I should mention is this attribute right here called step. As I described earlier, step has an impact on Pi process book by changing whether we see a stair step function or just connecting the dots in process book. That's the effect it has on actually looking at the data. But it does have an effect on how the compression test is done. If step is turned on, then the compression test simply turns into a second type of exception test. We don't account for slope at all in the compression test if step is turned on. So we simply do a second exception test using the compression deviation as the second value for that test. So that's what happens if we set step equal to on.